then definitely stick around through the end of the video because we're going to talk. Go on, sit down. Sit down. Don't yell at me. Her Royal Highness had to interrupt. Sorry about that. Hey, psst. Stop. What is up, you guys? I am Missy Renee, and in today's video, we're going to talk about the pearl of great price. Now, I know some of you know what I'm talking about, and some of you are probably looking at me right now like, what? But rest assured, this is something that you absolutely need to understand when it comes to manifesting. And speaking of manifesting, if this is a topic that you are interested in learning more about, definitely be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that way you're notified when I release new videos every week. If you're interested in more resources such as one-on-one coaching, I will leave the links down below in the description box, along with a number of other helpful resources, so do not forget to check them out. And this video was actually another subscriber request, and it's a video that I've been meaning to make for a long time because The Pearl of Great Price is a lecture from Neville Goddard, and it is one of my all-time favorite lectures from him. And in my opinion, it has the most valuable information and what you need to really know and understand when it comes to manifestation and conscious creation. So I'm going to be doing a deep dive on The Pearl of Great Price, on this amazing lecture, and giving you a breakdown as to what exactly this means and what you need to know when it comes to creating the life that you want. And I cannot stress it enough how important this video is. So if you are not familiar with The Pearl of Great Price, what this means, then definitely stick around to the end of the video because I'm going to talk about why this is so important, what The Pearl of Great Price means, and how this can absolutely open doors and give you an understanding into how to manifest the life that you want. And just a really quick announcement before we get started, I want to let you guys know about my upcoming workshop next Saturday, March 16th, all about self-concept mastery. If you watch my channel, you know that the self-concept and changing your self-concept is the cornerstone of conscious creation. So I'm going to be doing a deep dive into everything that you need to know and understand about how to change your self-concept and how to embody the version of you that you desire to be so that you can ultimately manifest whatever it is that you want. I'm going to be doing the workshop through my membership group, the Conscious Creator Society, which comes with a bunch of other perks and helpful resources such as all of my previously recorded workshops, live Q&A sessions, and a ton of really helpful tools and guides to help you on your journey. So if you are interested in signing up, I will have the link down in the description box below. And for a limited time, for those who sign up, we'll get 50% off the membership costs for life. So definitely be sure to check it out, take advantage of this offer, and I will see you all there soon. So as I've said, and as I've previously mentioned in a couple other videos, The Pearl of Great Price is a must-read lecture for anybody who is new to manifesting, or especially if you are new to the law. And even for those who have read it, I always suggest rereading it because every time you do, you're gonna get more and more from it. It is absolutely one of the most fundamental lectures, in my opinion, that Neville ever spoke about. If you have not heard this lecture or read this lecture yet, I'll have it down in the description box below. Definitely read it, listen to it. I'll have it available for PDF and on YouTube. But this is something that truly so many people grapple with and something that so many people really need to understand. And I wish that I had grasped this sooner myself. And really, after I read this lecture, something clicked for me. It really helped me to step up my game and ultimately give me the push that I needed to further along my conscious creation journey. So what the hell is the Pearl of Great Price? What does that even mean? In Neville's lecture, he talks about having to buy the pearl of great price. And to buy the pearl, that means that you need to give up any and all concepts, any and all beliefs, any and all assumptions in any power outside of you. To believe that anything else other than your imagination has any power outside of you, you are effectively not buying the pearl. The pearl of great price is that unquestioning, unwavering faith in your ability, in your power, in your imagination as the creator in your world. To buy the pearl, you need to go all in. You need to get rid of any and all question that you are the creator. There cannot be any room for doubt or any room to believe that there is a power outside of you that has any control over what happens to you. And it is because of this belief that there is something outside of you that holds power is why you struggle to manifest. You need to give up any and all of your old assumptions. You need to give up all of the past beliefs. It's giving up and surrendering that feeling of victimhood. You got to give up astrology. You got to give up the tarot cards. You got to give up any and all beliefs that there is a force or an energy or a power outside of your consciousness, outside of your own imagination. And this is the fundamental thing, that once you truly get this, and once you truly believe this and accept this, and once you buy that pearl, the world is yours for the taking. When you buy the pearl, you are stepping into your power and stepping into that unshakable faith that you are, in fact, the God of your reality. This is so important to really understand and really be able to do. If you want to be the creator, if you want to be the one that determines what happens in your world, you need to give up everything else that possibly looks, smells, or seems like an excuse. Now, I know from first thought that could seem pretty daunting, especially when you're new at this. But Missy, I don't have the faith yet. What do I do if I don't really believe this? What happens if I do believe in astrology or tarot cards or my chart that said this bad thing over here is going to happen? There's a trap that a lot of people fall into when we're new to manifesting, when we're just starting out, when we're just trying to figure out what's up from down. One of the biggest misconceptions that I have run into and that I've seen with my clients and that I subscribe to for a very long time is that we use manifestation to get something. The way that most people describe the law of attraction or the law of assumption is a way to get things. The way that most other YouTube coaches and manifestation gurus explain it and describe the law appears to be a thing that we do in order to get RSP or change people or create something. There is this view that if I do this thing, I'm going to get this thing. And by framing it this way, by framing manifestation as, oh, if you do this technique, you're gonna get this thing, it seems very attractive. And a lot of people are gonna wanna buy it. And yes, it is absolutely true that we can create our reality. Yes, it is absolutely true that we can manifest the life that we desire. It's really important to put things in perspective. And there is some context that really needs to be driven home. And if I have to repeat it over and over again, I will. Everything that we manifest, all of the people that change, manifesting that SP or changing your circumstances are an effect from the law. And it's why we are all students. It's why we all want to learn about this. We want to be able to change our circumstances, and we want to be able to manifest that SP back or more money or whatever it is that you want. But it's super important that you understand that your circumstances and manifesting that SP is an effect of what you do with yourself. Now, what do I mean by that? It is the effect of what you believe and what you assume and the concepts that you carry. The law is not about doing techniques to get certain things that we want. The law is about understanding that our imagination is our power. Our awareness, our consciousness is our power. It is about you and your mind and the connection that you have and the awareness that you have when it comes to the mind. The law is about your own growth and your own awakening. The law is about your development and your change and your expansion and your ascension. Everything else is an effect that gets pushed out. Everything that happens after that is an effect or a manifestation of just that, of your development and your growth. And it's so important to drive this home because there is still such a huge narrative that we need to change other people and other circumstances. No, we want to change ourselves. It is a change that comes from within. And as humans, we generally don't like the idea of change. We typically don't resonate with having to change ourselves. We want to change the things around us. But when it comes to doing the work within, it doesn't sound so attractive anymore. But there is no other way. There is nothing that you can manifest except by doing the work within. You cannot change your circumstances until there is first a change from within you. Any and all things that manifest happen as a result of the change that happens within. We are the cause, everything else is the effect. Everything else is just an effect of the law. So when I talk about buying the pearl, this is about accepting that there is nothing else that needs to happen except changing from within, about really doing the inner work and making that radical psychological change of the self. We cannot subscribe to this and also believe that the power lies within the techniques. We cannot subscribe to conscious creation and also believe that there is something outside of us that's doing the work for us. You either buy the pearl or you don't. You either subscribe to the inner transformation or you don't. And I know this sounds a little off-putting, but I need to be real with you guys because I still, even after saying over and over again that there is no technique out there that will do the work for you, I still have people try to come to me and say, what am I doing wrong? Where am I going wrong with sats? Where am I going wrong with my affirmations? I've been trying to revise, but it's not working. It's not the techniques. It is whether or not you are going all in with making that fundamental change of your self-concept. It is going all in and accepting that there needs to be a radical shift in perspective and there needs to be a transformation of the self. If you want this to be lasting and sustainable, you need to take the reins back. And I truly believe that it is the most important thing that you will ever do is by buying this pearl and really taking it all in. And I truly believe that this is something that everybody should subscribe to regardless of whether or not it sounds tedious, because you're always using this power. You are always manifesting. You are always creating. There is no stopping that fact. There is no exceptions to that rule. So it is best to understand, learn, and embrace this and really go all in versus giving your power away and being victim of circumstances and feeling hopeless and lost and jaded. You have the power to do anything that you want and control anything that you want and change any circumstances that you want. You have the power to absolutely transform anything that you desire. You can have all the things that you could possibly ever dream of, but first you have to buy the pearl. Now I'm going to read an excerpt from this lecture to give you guys a better idea. Everyone in the world is using this only power, but they don't know it. So he's trying to bring us to the knowledge of this power and the wise use of it. It's called, as we first quoted, the pearl of great price. So great is this pearl, so valuable, it takes everything that you own to buy it. Now, you don't go and liquidate your stocks and bonds. You don't sell your homes. You don't sell anything in the world of Caesar. But it takes everything that you now believe in other than it to pay for it. You believe in astrology? You've got to sell it. You believe in numerology, in teacup leaves, in all of these things? No matter what you believe in as power to control you, you've got to sell it. It takes the belief, all these beliefs, and you've got to sell them. No one will buy them from you, but you give them up as valueless. Therefore, there is no price attached, no value whatsoever. But you can't hold on to one thing you now believe in as power that controls your life and still hope to buy the pearl of great price. Everything you now believe in, whether it be even the drugs that you take, even the things, the diets, if you're a vegetarian and you think that is the way to God, if you're a meat eater and you think that's the way to God, if you're a non-smoker, non-drinker, and that's the way to God, or if you're a smoker and a drinker and that's the way to God, there is no way to God but Christ. I am the way. There is no other way. Way to what? To everything in this world, but especially the Father. No one comes into the Father but by me. And here he defines it, that he is the only way in the world to everything in this world that you and I seek. And it takes everything that we own, as to beliefs that we think are powers to guide our life, to pay for that pearl of great price. If you think for one moment you can hold on to one little thing in the event this doesn't work, you can't buy the pearl. And so, when I buy the pearl, I go all out and live by it. And there is no other being in this world, just the pearl, and I live by it. And this pearl is your own wonderful human imagination. And I know that this can seem very daunting, especially since we all want to believe that there is a quick fix or a miracle cure or something outside of us that can just take care of this problem for us. As humans, we naturally don't like the idea of change. We don't like the idea of having to change ourselves. But if you want to buy the pearl, if you want to create a life that you have always dreamed of, if you want to be free of the shackles and the chains that have bound you for all time, since you can remember, you need to buy the pearl. And when you do this, when you can go all in, and when you can truly embrace that your imagination is the creative power in your life, and you can build on that foundation, and you go through the inner work, and you go through the observation, when you finally do buy this pearl, you will become the master of your reality. That is when you manifest anything that you want. I've said over and over again about making this a lifestyle, and I wasn't kidding. If you want lasting change, if you want that transformation to manifest whatever it is that you want, keep those manifestations in your life, dwell in the state that you desire to be in, you have to buy the pearl. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in checking out any of my other resources, I will leave the links below to one-on-one coaching, my blog, and my social links. So definitely check them out. And don't forget to check out these videos over here. Each video is a different topic, but they all pertain in how to manifest the very best life possible. So until we meet again, you guys, take care, be well, and never forget, if you want to manifest that life you dream of, you gotta buy the pearl. Happy manifesting, y'all.